let's go back and talk about code, shall we? You came here to learn QML, to learn how to integrate your QML with C++. So that's definitely what we're going to do now. In this video, we will see a very simple application written in QML. We will talk about set order. We'll talk about how do we run this from QML, or from how do we run QML from Qt Creator. That's what I was trying to say. So let's just get started, shall we? What you're looking at here is Qt Creator. Let me just open up that QML file right away here. There we are. And you can see in Qt Creator, it allows, or it highlights our elements. So I got an item element here. I got a rectangle element. It even shows me help on the elements. I got a bunch of properties here. And even my light blue, I can see what light blue looks like. Awesome. Shall we run it first before we start talking about it? If I go down here, I have a button that I could press run on. Had it just worked? I'll tell you why it doesn't work. It doesn't work because I just loaded in one QML file. Qt Creator doesn't know whether it is this particular file that I want to run, or it's another file that I want to run that is imported by this file. So a QML project obviously is more than just one file, at least if it's more than Hello World. So therefore we need to tell Qt Creator which QML file is the main QML file. Had this been C++, again, I would need somewhere in my project to have an entry point or int main, whatever. In Qt Creator, what I need to do is that it's not open this file, but I need to open a file with the extension .qml project. And now when I open it up, you can see that my play button works. Let's just look at what does this, this file look like. So over here in my sidebar, which by the way, I got up by pressing L0. So L0 toggles it up and down. So let's look at this file here. It more or less looks like this every single project that you work on. Every single project that you work on without a C++ backend. We're gonna have C++. Remember, I said that this is my third video. C++, that is where we'll have our business logic. So most often you're not gonna have a QML project file, but for these initial test runs where you're just playing with QML, you will have a QML project file that looks more or less like this. Main file, you specify the name of your main QML file, and that's it. This file, back in the days with Nokia, they had the intention that you would have hundreds of QML files in libraries and whatnot, and you would pack all of those and put it on your phone. Purely QML application. That's not how the future played out. Back then, they had lots of intention for this file. But as I said, in your Hello World kind of playing around with QML, your file is going to look exactly like this. Okay, so now we got this application up and running here. Let's see what it looks like. So we got blue, light blue even, rectangle sitting here in the middle of the screen. Let's just read the user interface, what it looks like. We got an item. An item doesn't look like anything. It's just a container that you can put other stuff into. The item has 400 in width and 200 in height. That's what you see here. I'll bet you if you count the pixels, that's going to be 400 here and 200 in this direction. Inside this item, we have a rectangle. My rectangle is at position 100, 50, 100 pixels in, 50 pixels down. That's where my rectangle is. Its height is 100 pixels, so 100 pixel here, and its width is twice the height. See, that's already beautiful in QML. You have your properties are not just values. It's actually a JavaScript expression that you have on the right side. You don't believe me? That hurts my feeling, but I'll show you. Let me just show you right away. Let me just create a function here. Function. Let's call it foo. The function will be printing out, so console.log. There we are. hello world. And it needs to return a value. So it returns the height multiplied by 2. It goes like this. And now I can simply call that function up here. I can even in my hello world, I can do like this. So let's just run it. And you can see that it says hello world 200. Doesn't look entirely right. Why is that? Foo return. Oh man, I'm sure it's something simple. Do you know what it is?
I know what it is.
I'll tell you. It found the height of this item up here. So it found the height. The height is a free variable here that it will go and search for, and it's of course it'll find this one up there. So I just take my function, put it up here. Now you'll see when I run it that it again has the right width. Okay, so the right side of that property binding is actually a JavaScript expression. We'll talk much more about the property bindings in the next video. I also told you that the item doesn't look like anything. So let's just undo here. There we are, undone. And now let me just create another rectangle in here. Let me just cut and paste here. There we are. I got another rectangle here. And my first rectangle, or my second rectangle, let's put that at, so the height was, let me put it at 220. The same one, well, wrong. Let me put it at 170, there we are. And the X and the height and everything being the same, let me give it another color here. Let's do a beautiful green. And well, at least if I resize, you can see that it's sitting down underneath here. Let's actually try and make them overlap instead. Let's just go and 120 here and run it again. And you'll see that the green, just resize a bit again. See, the green is actually overlapping the blue. And the reason is simply the set order. So the set order is that the earlier in the file, the lower in the stack. You can simply think of it like, I got an item, here's a rectangle, I got another item, let me put that on top of the, then I had yet another rectangle, I'll put that on top. So you build, just like if you were playing with stamps or something and you were putting them out, laying them out, and some of them, the latter or the later you put something on the table, the higher its set order is. If I want, I can change the set order. I'll do that simply by, as you can figure out here, X, Y, and set. Oh, we just break here for our American friends watching us. Thank you for watching. When I say set, I really mean C. Why can't you just call it set over there? Anyway, set colon, and then I can bring this one below the other one, minus one, for example. And now the blue rectangle is overlapping the green one. How did you know that, Jesper? How did you know that it was called set? Or C? Well, if I couldn't guess it, and most properties I can't guess, I'll go to the reference documentation. The reference documentation is very easy to access from within Qt Creator. I'll put my cursor where I want to know something about it. I'll press F1, and here comes the reference documentation for my rectangle. I'll press F1 once more, I already did, and now it's taking up the full screen. And in here, I can see, there's no set here. Well, just as in C++, we have the concept of inheritance. So you can see here that my rectangle QML type inherits item. An item, well, that definitely has a lot of elements, so a lot of properties. So I'll read through all of these properties. And of course, the very last one that I'll hit is that set that I was interested in. And scroll up here and you can see that we have quite a bit of few things to talk about in this video series of QML. There's quite a few other elements that we can talk about, and we'll talk about many of them in different contexts. One thing I didn't talk about when we looked at this rectangle again is that its X position is 100. But what does that mean? 100 where? Let me try and draw it for you. So over here, I have my screen. My screen, this gigantic thing here, right? And then somewhere on my screen, I have this beautiful application with a light blue rectangle sitting inside a white area. And then my white area, the whole window here, that's what I set up when I specify here. I specify 400 by 200. Had I specified an X and a Y in here, then that would be the position on the screen. And then I got this light blue rectangle that sits in here, inside of my my white or my item, and it sits at position 100, 50. 100, 50. And the key thing, the key question to ask is, where is 0, 0? Well, it's 0, 0 is the topmost, leftmost corner of its parent element. So up here, that is 0, 0. Had this element been sitting inside another element that was sitting inside yet another element that was sitting inside the application that was sitting on the screen, then still my 100, 50 is relative to the topmost, leftmost corner of this element. That's it for this video. If you have any questions or any comments, please feel free to post them in the comment field below. The next video we're going to see is on property bindings. We already saw a bit of property bindings here with colon height multiplied by 2. But I'll get back and tell you much more about property bindings in the next video. We'll also see how we get pointers inside QML. It's basically an ID element that we can reference from other elements. Until then, have a good time.